Sunal, before I get to what the RBI can do and will be doing, I want to talk to you about how you're reading the overall situation, the data points available to us right now. In a note as of the 12th of September, you've alluded to the fact that the economic outlook remains rather weak, despite due to weak growth, balance of payment pressures, cost push inflation, and rising political and fiscal risks. Explain to us, despite taper not being around, would you still hold this view?
So I think, you know, one has to differentiate between the near-term view and, you know, sort of a more, slightly more medium-term view. I think near-term, you know, the decision to not taper clearly gives all emerging markets, including India, some breathing space. So if portfolio flows are going to come back into emerging markets, then the pressure we were facing because of a high current account deficit, that is going to moderate. So the near-term pressure because of balance of payment on the currency clearly is going to go away because of this decision. So near-term, this is clearly a positive for the economy. And to the extent that the RBI starts rolling back its liquidity tightening measures, that will also be near-term positive. But I think, you know, if you go beyond the liquidity money, the liquidity flow, I think the underlying growth momentum is extremely weak. I mean, there are real issues in the economy, which is one, inflation is still stuck at 9 to 10% range. Mm. Inflation expectations are stuck at double-digit range. The balance sheet of both banks and companies are in a pretty bad shape. So to expect, you know, a sudden revival in private demand is clearly something we don't think is going to happen. Mm. So the growth outlook remains weak. Inflation remains very sticky because of supply side reasons. Mm. And what we've got right now is essentially some breathing space on the external sector.
Sure.
I think that's how broadly we would classify it.